Well, ladies and gentlemen, girls and boys, down in the Spotless Stadium is two delightful people. And there's a young lady down there that works at the Camden Show, and she does announcing out there too. And alongside her is a man that has had great success as a rural ambassador here in your state of New South Wales as well. Both of them have, in fact. And I'd love you to put your hands together for the lovely Lindsay Douglas and Sam Martin. Give them a nice warm welcome here this afternoon.
Well, thank you very much, Angus. We are delighted to be here, ladies and gentlemen, because we are here for a pretty exciting event. This is the state final of the Young Farmer Challenge, and there's a huge amount on the line here today, isn't there, Sam?
There is, Lindsay, and it's very exciting. Our teams, four teams, have been going hard at it all day. They've progressed from heats of 12. 12 other teams have qualified through their regional shows, and they're vying for $2,000 and to be crowned our New South Wales Young Farmer Challenge winners and go on to compete at a national level in the end of the year in Adelaide.
And that's right. Look, New South Wales has a huge amount on the line when it comes to the Australian competition, because not only did we win last year, we won the year before that as well. So we want to make sure we send through the very best team from New South Wales to take on the Queenslanders and the Victorians at the national level.
Well, Lindsay, it looks like we're getting into the final setups of our challenge, and this wouldn't be possible without our sponsors who have provided us all this fantastic equipment. So if we look up to the big screen and just acknowledge our wonderful sponsors that make the 2016 Young Farmer Challenge a possibility.
That's right, Sam. We've got the wonderful sponsors from the Royal Agricultural Society of New South Wales, and they bring us the state part of the Australian Young Farmer Challenge. But this event is brought to us by the Royal Agricultural Society of New South Wales Youth Group, which are some wonderful volunteers from all over New South Wales who just love making sure young people are involved in agriculture. We've got some commercial sponsors as well that have come on board this year.
We'd like to thank Honda, and they've got those wonderful red quad bikes.
Well, We had a ball today out in the Schmidt Arena where teams had to compete across a series of activities. They had a vegetable challenge where they had to find root vegetables. We had an aquaculture challenge where they had to determine whether certain fish were native or introduced to Australia. We had a challenge whereby they had to manoeuvre various vehicles. They had to put out a fire at a different point. But before all of that, they had to do a theoretical or an academic challenge about agriculture, because today's farmer needs to know an awful lot about economics and business practices and certain pesticides. And our teams that made it through to the final, the state final we're about to see, they sat another exam this afternoon whereby they were asked about meteorological data and they were asked about various breeds of sheep and cattle, and that determined their handicaps today. So when we start off later, you're going to notice that some teams start early on and others, well, they're held back a little bit longer.
And Lindsay, for all our people that have been around the show, it's a bit like the wood chop. So we'll start with a count and their handicap is determined, and we're not far off our teams. But if you're wondering the quick run sheet of how today is going to work, we start over with our wonderful Kubota tractors, and they have to back them with the trailer back 30 metres. This is often a skill required, reversing, and you're trying not to hit anything. I know personally I've nudged the odd farm gate, but we'll see our teams keep it on the gravel and keep on moving backwards.
That's right. Then they'll move on to the gate challenge, where they will need to assemble a gate and latch it here in the main arena before they move on to the farrier challenge brought to us by TAFE New South Wales. Do you know there's 69 master farriers in New South Wales alone? And you can actually train to be a farrier at TAFE. Here they are going to use the cold shoeing method and reshape a horseshoe.
Very good. And we move on then to our roping challenge, whereby teams will have to rope their cow. This is a paper cow for purpose today, and roping is commonly seen in rodeo, and we'll see a bit later on tonight, but it's also used where yards are not accessible and animal management practices are needed to be done. We then move on to our goat, which we talked about earlier, and they will have to mouth the goats, guessing the age of the goats via the teeth, and they will then move on to their next challenge.
That's right, they'll move on to the safety challenge next, a huge focus of the Young Farmer Challenge, which, by the way, occurs all over New South Wales, and there's regional competitions happening all the time in order to get through to Sydney Royal Easter Show. They have to really demonstrate that they understand safe practice on farm, and in this particular challenge, they're going to put on some personal protective equipment before they move on to a series of challenges where they'll move hay bales, put out a fire, and then take that protective gear off. They'll also be moving utes throughout this session. They're going to manoeuvre a quad bike as well. So I think there's three different vehicles they have to master here today. And their final challenge, Sam, I think is my favourite one of all.
I think it is. It's a melon challenge, and they've got to get their chariots all together. They have to collect the melons off the ground, which are our balls on the ground, place them in the chariots, and it's a dash for cash. And it really is, Lindsay, with $2,000 up for grabs for our New South Wales Young Farmers Challenge winners.
I reckon it's about time we get to meet our teams, because today we saw 11 teams from all over New South Wales compete, but there's only four that have made it through to this state final. I reckon we should get to meet each of our team members. What do you think, Sam?
I think that's a fantastic idea, Lindsay.
So if you cast your eye, ladies and gentlemen, up into the big screen, we're going to introduce you to a couple of the competitors from each of our teams. Well, in lane one, they're the team in blue, and they're from the gorgeous little town on the south coast, Berry. It's Marty Downs. He's a 31-year-old dairy farmer. He's joined by another dairy farmer, Maddie Miller. She's only 20 years old, but by goodness, she showed us what she can do today. Bill Miller, her brother, is 23 years old. He's also a dairy farmer. Shame there isn't a dairy challenge here for them. And it's a 21-year-old builder, Chad Walker from Shoalhaven Heads, rounding out their team for Berry.
And moving on to lane two, to our next team from Albion Park in the red, and Ben Suckling from Oak Flats, the 24-year-old machine operator. He's accompanied by one of my favourite, the bearded man, Luke Wilson, from Jamberoo, 23, and he's another dairy farmhand. Leonard Dean and his team call him the Talking Champion. He's from Jamberoo. He's 26 and he's a dairy machine technician. And rounding out the team is Katie Whitaker from Blackbutt, age 22, and she's a nurse.
Well, in lane three, it's the Gen Ag team. They represent shows from all around New South Wales, but they are all from Mullumbimby up on the north coast of New South Wales. It's Alice Henson. She's a hairdresser and she's 20 years old. Darren Hambley is a 21-year-old mechanic from Mullumbimby as well. Scott Beaumont is the local butcher and he's 24 years old. And the retail guy is actually in delivery as well. He works with electrical equipment. It's Mitchell Ward, a 21-year-old from Mullumbimby. That's our Gen Ag team.
And rounding out our team, and because in New South Wales we're kind, Canberra is part of this team and they'll be wearing yellow. And Matt Sheehy is from Yarra. He's 24 and he's a station hand. Sam Brown is from Burrell. He's 25 and he's a rural contractor. Tara Smith is from Goulburn. She's 29 years old and she's a farmhand. And Kimberly Sykes rounds out our competitors from Goulburn, age 19, and she is also a farmhand. And Lindsay, before today as our final, as our teams are moving out, you said you look at the occupations for the early form guide when you're looking to support a team. And what's your hot pick early on today?
Well, I know it's probably a bit dodgy to say it before we even start, but I thought the Canberra team today were outstanding. They've got four people on their team that all are in really practical different occupations on the farm. So they're my pick today. Who are you getting behind?
I did like the team from Canberra, but I think the team from Albion Park's my favourite. They got the big bearded man in there and the larrikin, and I did enjoy them during their sessions today, so I'm very much looking forward to seeing them. But with all these challenges, you know, we saw it in the Smith Arena, it comes down to your ability to complete the task properly.
That's right. So today, ladies and gentlemen, you're going to see four people out in very smart blazers out here, and they are the judges with each of the lanes. They've got a massive responsibility because they need to make sure that the integrity of the competition is there, that safety is shown, and that correct techniques are used. So if you see a red flag go up, it means that the team right in front of you has done something wrong. They've either done something that's unsafe or not quite within the competition rules. If the flag goes up, that means that team has got to stop dead in their tracks. They cannot go any further. They can be penalised with 3, 5, or 10 second penalties. And in this particular race, speed is of essence.
Yeah, it's the combination of speed and efficiency, isn't it, Lindsay? And we've got to get things done right and properly. So it's going to be very interesting as we go through our final briefings and just finish off. We're not far away from starting our competition of the 2016 New South Wales Young Farmers Challenge, and it's a dash for $2,000. Hey, Lindsay.
Yes, Sam.
I got told when I came out here I had to say a really good dad joke.
No, Sam, your jokes are awful.
Lindsay, what do you get when you cross a tractor with a robot?
When you cross a tractor with a robot, I don't know.
A transformer.
A transformer. Ladies and gentlemen, this is what I have to put up with every year.
So, ladies and gentlemen, we're not far off our final challenge here. Just a reminder, they start with the tractors, where they have to reverse them back. They sprint over here, set up the gates. We then move on to the lassoing challenge, to the farrier challenge, to the goat challenge, to the PPE challenge. We'll take a breath there because I think they'll need a breath themselves. And then where do we go from there, Lindsay?
We move on to a hay challenge from there. We also get them to manoeuvre the utes around a course. They have to put out a fire. They've got to manoeuvre a quad bike. And then they've got to get a melon chariot over the final finish line.
And I heard these melon chariots' structural integrity aren't the best, so they can't go too fast because the wheels might fall off, and they have to get the chariot over the line intact. So we'll go back through our teams here, Lindsay, and just let everyone let out a cheer for the teams they're supporting, and I think we're not too far off having a start here for the 2016 Young Farmers Challenge.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. You've got an important decision to make now. We just introduced you to each of those teams. So these are your options. You can go for the team from Berry, who are on the gorgeous part of the south coast on your way down to all the gorgeous beaches down there. You can go to the team from Albion Park, who have shown they're particularly practical today. You can go for the team from Mullumbimby, way up on the north coast, if that's your preference. Or you can get behind the team from Canberra, the nation's capital, and they're quietly my bet. So I want to hear a bit of a cheer for each of those, depending on which one you're going to get behind. Are you supporting the team from Berry? Well, that's okay. Well, that's all right.
I think it's all right. I think Sydney can get louder, though.
Well, let's see who's going to get behind the ones close to us. The team from Albion Park. Hey, they're pretty popular. That's all right. The team in red. All right, who's going to get behind our green team? Jenag from Mullumbimby.
Few from the North Coast there. And who's going to get behind the team from the nation's capital, Canberra?
Whoa, they are popular.
Or there's a few too many politicians in the room.
Oh, that'd be terrible. I'm kidding. So there are our four teams here today, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to check in with our officials and we'll be back with you very shortly to get this competition on the road.
Just go round. Is our team from Berry in blue ready?
Is our team from Albion Park in red ready?
Is our team from Jenag in green ready?
And finally, the team from Canberra in yellow, are you ready? Now, ladies and gentlemen, as I told you earlier, there is a handicap here, so I'm going to count it out. There'll be some teams starting on 5 seconds, two teams starting on 9 seconds, and one team who didn't do so well in the theoretical part starting at 12 seconds.
Right, competitors, are you ready? Sydney, are you ready? On my marks, get set, go!
One, two, three, four, five.
And our team from Canberra is
seven,
off.
8, 9, 10, 11.
We got Berry 12. And Albion Park going, and our last team, Generation Ag from Mullumbimby, is off and running as well.
Well, it's the team from Canberra here who are going nice and steady as they're backing up. Their Kubota tractor, a solid 30 metres. You can see that the officials are walking by them. They're making sure that they do not touch the track, because if they do, they will be disqualified.
And we got a good early start by our team from Albion Park. They've really raced off, and I think they're going to be the team in the lead. And they're in front of our Sydney Royal stand, and they're closely followed by a team in blue from Berry. How's it looking over your side, Lindsay?
Well, I've got the team from Generation Ag here. They're not going nearly as quickly as the team from Canberra. I knew they'd be the ones to beat early on. The team from Canberra have now moved on to the fencing challenge. They need to set up a fence from scratch, and they need to latch it before they're allowed to move on. But the team from Jenag, Mullumbimby, well, they're still doing the tractor challenge.
Well, over here in front of the Sydney Royal stand, our team here in the blue from Berry has got their gate set up, and they're moving along quite nicely with a clear lead. And our team from Albion Park here, after their good lead, they're really struggling to put together this gate.
Well, they're not as far too far ahead, because right behind them is a team from Canberra. It's Matt, Sam, Tara and Kimberly right behind them for the New South Wales TAFE Farriers Challenge.
And so they've got to assemble a horseshoe here. They've got the outline, and this is a very important practice. In all times, the farriers travel with the horses, and they're a bit like people. Horses require a different shoe for each horse, and it's not one size fits all. So they've got an outline, and they have to create these horseshoes, and we've got our teams well and truly underway.
Well, this is a cold shoeing model that you're seeing, or method that you're seeing here. They've got aluminium horseshoes, they've got an anvil, hammer and tongs. They've got to get it into shape. Now, you can see the judges actually saying no a lot here, but I believe we've got the blue and the red team are already off. They'll be moving on now to the roping challenge. Now, this is an important skill, particularly on particularly large farms where you're not always in arm's reach of your beast. You need to make sure that you know how to use a rope in order to get your steer or your calf. And here they have two chances each for each team member. And if they can't get that done within each of the team's two goes, they will be held up with a time penalty.
So a lasso, traditionally, it started off in America, but they're a heavy-duty rope, and they can be up to 35 to 40 foot long for your traditional ropes, and it's great to see these are sort of hybrid ones. The ropes are normally stiffer from your standard lasso, and we see our teams are struggling with the lassoing here, Lindsay.
Hey, did you know that the average Australian eats 33 kilos of beef every year?
And isn't it delicious?
It is delicious. And it is the equivalent of 165 steak sandwiches. That's how much we eat each year.
Very good. And I think we should eat more of it. And we've got our lasso challenge here and our teams with none actually getting a chance to rope. But it looks like our team from Canberra over the far side have lassoed their beast and they're on to mouthing their goats over there, and this is a challenge that's commonly done to age livestock on properties, and you'll see sheep and goats start off with their milk teeth and then they get two teeth up the middle and then they go to four teeth and they go to six teeth, and that dictates their age too, so it goes as they mature as an animal.
Well, I'm standing over here now with the team from Canberra. They've already correctly identified the age of the goat by mouthing the goat. The judge has given them the nod, and now they're on to coating the goat. And this is the process whereby they put a coat on the goat after it's been fleeced so that it can protect the fleece growing. That means that it's nice and clean, no dust, no contaminants, but they are in the lead at the moment, the team from Canberra, but not far behind at all are the guys in green, Jen Ag, Mullumbimby. It's Canberra now who are off to the safety challenge. They're going to throw on their PPE gear, and that is their protective personal equipment that they need to put on before they go anywhere near a fire at all. You can see the team now all proving that teamwork matters and actually dressing the one person that needs to be dressed for this challenge. They've got the goggles on, they've got the jacket on, they're getting the gloves on, and then the team is going to join them on a bit of a run with a couple of hay bales.
Lindsay, it's almost like a human scarecrow competition at the moment.
It certainly is, Sam. Well, it's the team from Canberra in the yellow shirts now that are running around the witch's hat and making their way over to their hay bales.
They'll give a truckie's hitch, and then they'll then be moving forward in the utes through to the next challenge.
That's right. So one of their drivers will get in. They need to put their seatbelt on. Everything needs to be safe here. They will drive at an appropriate speed and then pull up at the other end of the track. There, their teammates will join them once they've fully been pulled up by the judges. Here you can see the team from Canberra eager to get over to their ute, but their judges told them, no, hold up. You're not allowed over there just yet. Now, once they've been given the go-ahead, which they've just been given by the judge, they need to take all the bales off the back of the Hilux and place them at the front of the ute. They're well and truly in the lead here at the moment, the team from Canberra, and not far behind are the guys from Generation Ag.
Well, Lindsay, I think you need to look back over to the right, and we've had a strong finish here by the team from Berry, and we're starting to move on to the five challenge now. And as we saw earlier in the Smith Arena, it was a real bottleneck. They have to start these fire pumps, and this is kindly done by the Rural Fire Service, and these guys do an absolute wonderful job. They have to prime the pumps, get the pumps going, get the water going through them, and put out this fire.
Hey Sam, did you know that there are 2,053 rural brigades, fire brigades across New South Wales, and they're wonderful volunteers. Actually, ladies and gentlemen, how about a hand for our Rural Fire Service?
So we look like the team from Canberra's recouped their lead, and the team from Berry looks like they've got a little bit of a penalty there. Our judge Tim pulled them up earlier as they start to move on. Our team from Next Generation Ag and our team from Albion Park is bringing out the tail.
Well, that's right. So we've got the fire going out now for the team from Canberra, and they're running like billy-o off to their next challenge. And the next challenge is going to be the one where they move their quad bikes, brought to us by Honda. They're going to get their quad bike around a short course here before they make their way on to the finale with the Melon Chariot.
And Lindsay, they've got their spray tanks on the back, and this is very common for farming practices to get rid of those unwanted weeds out of your pasture. So they'll move along and got the correct PPE on, and they'll move along and they have to spray each one of these flower pots to get the unwanted weeds out of them. and they'll move forward. And it looks like we've got a real bottleneck here. But our team from Berry in blue look like they've got a little bit of a lead here.
Well, I'll tell you what, we've now got a bit of a stall over here with our quad bikes. It's the team from Mullumbimbery and the team from Canberra that are really not moving at the pace they'd want to be moving at this end of the competition. And while they're heading over to do their noxious weeds and spray them, did you know that there are 44 different types of noxious weeds in New South Wales, according to the Department of Primary Industries? That's an awful lot of getting rid of weeds that farmers need to do.
It's an awful lot, and our team from Berry, who are over in front of the members' stand, are well and truly away. They've got everything they need there. They've just been pulled back, and away they go, and they're on to the Melon Challenge. Our team from Canberra is also on their Melon Challenge, and our teams here have to build their carts, Lindsay, and it looks like it's going to be a real dash for cash.
It certainly is. Look, we've been given these chariots and they're actually not particularly well assembled, as we mentioned before. So this isn't just a horticulture challenge. This is a challenge about the practical ability to get a basic bit of machinery up and running. And right now I can see the team from Canberra busily pulling together their particular chariot. Now, if at any point this falls apart on their final dash, they will be disqualified. So the quality of their chariot is most important.
Lindsay, I think if we're placing these teams, it's very close between the team in lane four from Canberra and the team in lane one from Berry. Next Generation Ag's putting in a good performance, and Albion Park is just lagging behind a little bit here, but they're just about to see their dash for cash, and this is the dash for $2,000 and the opportunity to compete at national finals representing your hometown, New South Wales.
Well, I can see it's the team now from Canberra that are busy picking up their melons. Do you know that a watermelon is 92% water? They're about to cross the finish line. It's the team from Canberra who will take out the State Young Farmer Challenge for 2016.
And closely followed by the team from Berry. And in third place, as they move along, we've got our team from Next Generation Ag up at Mullumbimby.
Well, they were just seconds in it there, Sam. Well, ladies and gentlemen, crossing the line first, the fabulous team from the nation's capital with a time of 10 minutes and 27 seconds. They're looking like they don't have much oxygen getting into their lungs right now, but I'm going to have a quick chat to you. I'm going to join you, get you to look up here with me. Now tell me, hardest part of today's challenges so far?
The running constantly, especially in the big arena. It was all right in the Smith Arena, but I think the guys like to sort of torture us a little bit and just spread everything out too much. So, we're used to tractors and not running too much. So, tested us a little bit.
Time to talk to one of the ladies. Now, what particular skill did you discover you had today that you didn't know you had?
Running. There's a lot of running and you don't have to do that much on a farm. You have dogs and quad bikes for that.
Fantastic. They're important. They're important, our dogs and their quad bikes, aren't they? They can help us get a lot of things done a little more efficiently. Now, can you tell us a bit about the team here today? Where are they from? Who are they?
Well, we're all a bit of a mix, actually. We're all from Goulburn, but, I mean, I didn't know most of these guys when I started this team, and now we're best mates. Like, we all work in ag jobs, loving it, and this is what we wanted to do.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winning team to 2016. They'll be going on to the national finals, the team from Canberra.
Ladies and gentlemen, and our last team from Albion Park just crossed the line, coming in fourth place. If we can have a round of applause in a moment for our RAS youth group, who do a wonderful job at promoting agriculture to all the next generation, and to our contestants of the 2016 New South Wales Young Farmer Challenge.
So, Sam, we had the biggest privilege of organising and being part of today out back in the Schmidt Arena and being part of this awesome competition. It's only been around a few years in Australia, but now it's happening at shows all over New South Wales and, in fact, all over Australia.
Yes, Lindsay, and if you want to get a part of it or the opportunity to come here to the Sydney Royal Easter Show to compete, contact your local show in your local area, travel outside of Sydney and go to a local show, compete there, win and come back here. It's a great competition. I think we're not too far off sashing the winners. And it's been an absolute privilege here with you today, Lindsay. We've had a lot of fun in the Smith Arena, seen some falls, some great fishing and some great entertainment. And we look forward to having everyone back here next year for the next bit of the New South Wales Young Farmers Challenge.
That's right. So if you actually thought today, hey, I'd like to get out there and have a go at that, there's no reason that you can't. All the information is on the RAS website. Just Google Young Farmers Challenge and you could get a team organised as well. Go to your local show, compete there, and we may well see you at Sydney Royal Easter Show next year. But I reckon we're nearly ready to do some sashing.
So we're not far off getting our sashes coming out to the ring, and we've got the absolute pleasure of having the RAS president, Robert Ryan, OAM, out here to present the awards. We've also got our chief ring steward, John Bennett, and he does a wonderful job at making sure everything works perfectly in this main arena for your entertainment. And we've also got Councillor, the lovely Alison McIntosh, out here to sash our ribbons. So we're very lucky to have these three distinguished guests, and it shows the importance of the Farmers Challenge to the RAS. And we'll get our sashing underway and our pack up very soon. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll have our teams to come over to the podium for the official sashing. And in third place today, we had the team in green, and that is your team, Generation Ag from Mullumbimby. And in second place, Lindsay, we had the team in blue, and that is our team from Berry.
That's right. This was the team made up of dairy farmers. We had Marty Downs, Maddie Miller, Bill Miller, and Chad Walker, the token builder they brought along with them here today. That's the team from Berry. The Gen Ag team that came in third, I'll give you their names quickly. That was Alice Henson, Damien Hambley, Scott Beaumont and Mitchell Ward there in third place, Gen Ag Mullumbimby. You can see them now being presented by the Royal Agricultural Society of New South Wales, President Robert Ryan, OAM. He's sashing each of the members of the team from Mullumbimby right now. They had a valiant fight and they're only seconds behind our first and second place getters.
So once again, we're moving to our team in second place from Berry, Lindsay, the dairy farmers team.
That's right. These are the three dairy farmers and their builder. It's Marty Downs, Maddie Miller, Bill, her brother, and Chad Walker. And this competition's for people aged 18 to 35 years of age. We've got a couple of people here who are just 18 and a couple of people who are nudging 35. So it spans the youth age bracket, that's for sure.
Don't tell them, like, seriously.
And New South Wales, your 2016 Farming Challenge champions are the team from Canberra.
That's right. We've got Marty Shea, the 24-year-old station hand. Sam Brown, the 25-year-old rural contractor. Tara Smith, the 29-year-old farmhand. And Kimberly Sykes is also a farmhand, but she's only 19 years old. The team from Canberra, I'll tell you what, they really impressed us today out in the Schmidt Arena. And when it came to the crunch, they really showed they had the goods out here in the main arena, Spotless Arena as well.
So, ladies and gentlemen, that is your champions. That is your placings for the 2016 Young Farmers Challenge. And we're very excited to have them all here. Think about a team for next year. Think about all the hard work you do. And that wraps it up for the 2016 Young Farmers Challenge.